Hey, what's
Hi.
Up?
Hello.
Welcome back. How are you doing?
This is my mother.
Hi.
Hi. Nice to meet you. I'm Patty.
Nice to meet you.
A while ago, I went to a tattoo shop to get a consultation about a tattoo I wanted to get. My mom is coming with me for this tattoo. She came with me for my first tattoo, but specifically I want her there for this tattoo because it is her father.
Are you ready? Excited?
I am excited. She's nervous.
You're nervous?
A little bit.
Well, that's mom's job, right?
I'm definitely okay being there with Shauna. I've been there with every tattoo.
You know, if I have to be honest with you, we have a couple of things that we have to kind of really talk about. I've never really done a tattoo for somebody your size before. So I just want to make sure that we get the information that we want to display responsibly and appropriately. So we might have to make some changes, but I took what you had originally given me and I came up with some cool ideas. Okay. So I just need some input from you.
Right? Feel free to put input in.
Yes, please, please, but not too much.
Because it is her father. The inspiration behind the tattoo I want to get for this is for my grandfather. He passed away this recent Valentine's Day. And he was a gambler, and he liked chocolate-covered cherries, so that's the whole kind of inspiration behind the theme of the tattoo.
I'm gonna make it look like you could actually eat it.
I think it's really special that she's getting a tattoo about my dad and her pap-pap, and, you know, that it means so much to her, and it means a lot to me.
So with realism, size equals information.
Yeah.
The more realistic we make it, the bigger it has to be, or the less things need to be in it. So this is actually really not gonna work so well for where you're putting it and the size and your unique, you know, anatomy.
Situation.
Sizing her tattoo is definitely gonna be a little challenging. It is a unique situation. We just have to make sure that it's done properly, but still delicate enough to make sure that she gets the tattoo that she wants, but we do it in a responsible way where her tattoo could look good forever. Well, I think I got it all buttoned up.
Okay.
Ready to do your tattoo? Come on back.
Yeah.
Mom, you can grab a seat.
Thank you.
Today I'm getting a tattoo done in remembrance of my grandfather.
Let's work.
I looked over and she looked like she was 10 years old, and then she was getting a tattoo, so I was a little bit confused. Especially seeing her get a tattoo, like, because of her situation, it was interesting.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm okay.
Are you?
I'm okay.
Are you really?
I'm okay.
Did you have that "it's fine" voice?
That's okay.
One of the drawbacks of having my mom there is she's very cautious about the whole tattoo process. She would prefer that I hide all my tattoos, and I'm just not that kind of person.
I'm just thinking that it's going on your body for the rest of your life, so, you know, you want to make sure it's perfect. That's all. And that maybe you can hide it if you have to hide it.
All right, ready?
Mm-hmm. See, Mama just tickles.
Is that what you call that?
Yeah. I don't know. I've had needles in my body my entire life.
True.
I know that you were saying things haven't always, like, really been easy for you. I mean, what are some of the things that you've been through that really stick out?
When I was 6 months old, I was diagnosed with stage 4 brain cancer.
Oh, my God.
Thankfully, I do not remember most of it.
I'm sure it was very difficult for everybody involved. Mm-hmm.
I think Shauna has definitely grown with her confidence. And tattooing, that world, they seem accepting of her. So it's a cool place to be.
You're a pretty tough chick, you know that?
Well, thank you. I didn't know that. People just think I'm annoying.
Why is that? I don't
see that. Oh, because I'm outspoken and...
You mean you're the way that you should be?
Yeah.
People just aren't ready for it?
No, they're not.
It's unfortunate. Sometimes people can base their thought of you before you've even actually said anything or done anything.
It is nice when you find someone like Joel who wants to ask those questions and doesn't want to be super, super nosy or offensive and is just curious and wants to learn about it. And it was nice talking to him because, one, he understands it, but, two, I think we both walked away with an understanding about a different human being And he had even said, like, this was my first time tattooing someone who's short, so this is a new experience for me. And I think it helped him, even though he may not realize it, or maybe he does, and it's helped me even if I don't realize it.
You found a way to be comfortable with yourself. And
yeah, I mean, it took a little bit, but
I have to be 100% honest. Like, I sit in this chair and I tattoo a lot of people, and everybody has their own story. Everybody comes from a different walk of life. Mm-hmm. But it's very rare that I meet somebody like you that literally owns the stage. Like, you're a lot like me. Like, you could walk into a room where nobody knows you mm-hmm. and own the room.
Yeah.
And before you leave, everybody knows that you were there.
Yeah.
I probably don't feel as confident as I give off. Most of the time, I am faking it. And that's what you have to do, because confidence is something that you gain. It's not something that happens overnight. It's not something that's given to you. So I think I'm working on getting my confidence to the way people see it, but it's not there yet. A little bit of it is faked because I just have so many insecurities still. And until they're all gone or until I can overshadow them, I will not be at 100% confident.
Do you like it?
I like it. That's awesome.
Want to keep it?
Yeah, I guess we'll keep it.
Want to put it on you?
It'll stay right here.
The finished tattoo was perfect. I think it came out very well for not just me, not just him, but for my mom and for my grandfather.
Do you like it?
I love it. Thank you for letting me do it.
You ready?
I've always been fascinated by piercings, and I always wanted them. But my mom would talk me out of getting a piercing. That's why I didn't tell her.
She ended up getting two. I had no idea.
Surprise! I'm getting piercings.
So I was like, oh my gosh.
If they say your body is your temple, let's decorate it.
You're so scared.
You do you.
She's more scared than you are.
I know. She's always been very open with me getting my ears pierced, so I didn't think it was going to be a huge issue. It wasn't one of those areas that were kind of like a maybe, a no, towards the no area. It was an area that I knew I could do whatever I wanted with, and she would accept it, even if she didn't like it.
All right, my dear. Nice deep breath in and out. You okay?
Mm-hmm.
Ah! So hold on, you got a needle in your head.
Oh my god.
Seeing those bars just sticking out of my child's ear? No, oh, I was like, oh my.
They say that's the most painful. That didn't hurt that bad.
Good.
It was also your first time seeing a piercing ever like that.
Right.
So
I think, well, it was beneficial that you didn't have to watch it.
I've watched. I know what's gonna happen to my body before I do things. I like it. I really like it.
Mm-hmm. I am definitely glad there. We're only in one ear. I don't know how much I could have taken, but yeah. I think
my other ear looks plain now.
It is.
If you compare.
Well, it is a little bit. You might need some dressing over
yeah.
there.
Yeah.
We'll talk about that later.
May my mama miss puke.